fumble ado. And then I have with somebody where you want for listen to. This person, like somebody where you don't hear him, sometimes you don't see him. But you can hear him and see him in a different light. This person, like no less a person, but the wife of the presidential candidate of the Sierra Leone People's Party, Mrs. Fatima Biyo. Mrs. Fatima Biyo, Kabo, and welcome to this interview.
Thank you, Andrew.
Fine. This is a special interview. Mrs. Fatima Biyo, first of all, who that's not Mrs. Fatima?
It's not for starting. I'm just one ordinary woman. We happen to be a retired leader to just not be a wife. In terms of qualifications, I know a lot of people study me as an actress and a journalistic moment. So I'm a mother. House a mini kindergarten for all the people in my neighborhood. I'm just a simple woman who believes in Africa. And as I've been saying, I don't champion a lot of charitable organizations around the world, and I don't campaign for a lot of other organizations around the world. I don't campaign for breast cancer awareness. Of course, I don't champion the Johnny Tapper Foundation. I don't work for the Johnny Foundation. I don't work for a lot of foundations. And then I get me away at the deal with Nathan the Fabric's promotions, where at the deal with all charitable issues. And now I don't have to say I get an opportunity where me and my man don't come together with union humanitarian side and me on humanitarian side. We decide to come and put together the Mother and Fatima Biyo Foundation, where they champion the well-being of women and the well-being of people. We know they just sideline man them, but we know say when it comes to the group of people that are working more affected in most issues, of women and people.
Yeah.
So, me and I just, in one word, should I say, I'm just a humanitarian person.
Okay.
I believe in human capital and human development.
You know, you're not possible when I see you, but everybody know you do feel something like you very well. So how you use that particular tendency we get for help in the campaign of people's life?
It's much easier for me because since I've been into the film industry for the last 8 years, and when you're in front of cameras, when you shoot a movie, you get all kind of people around you, you get everybody, and in order for say no, I know they talk because you get too many people there. They're part of the production. So that helped me for able to stand before people and actually address the issues. And when I believe in something, when I believe, when I get a conviction, say waiting at the door is the right thing, or waiting on a subject matter is waiting people they need for hearing, I know they get shame for able to stop myself. It drives me because when I want to say the truth, it's just difficult for them to shut up. I don't know when to shut up when I say the truth. I don't know when. Because I need for say I'm done, and then wait for the consequences later. But I believe say the filming industry or the filming environment don't help me more to be an outspoken person or able to discuss issues and able to make people understand.
Again, we see so many unlikely 2012 elections. This 2018 look a little bit different for me. It's a bizarre. You know, somebody want for suspecting. Maybe that your presence don't bring all them video clips, all them different fabulous posters all over the place. You know, you got any hands in that? Tell me.
Well, now I say all of the secret before I get another job. Somebody go employ me as a media consultant just now. But I'm a media person, and I know what in the media capable of doing. I believe in visualization. I believe, say, when you see a person every day, you become curious. Even the brain they tune into that phase. 2018 election, because I'll not be there at 2012, but I know say the 2018 election, we get for change the game, and we get for make people they actually understand who that na the candidates them, and the pictures, the social media, the interviews. Everything is a teamwork. We get collective people doing this, doing that. Me, now one side no more a day, pressing the button. But then you get other people where, when we say, you know what, the posters, when we hit, it hits the whole of Sierra Leone at one go. When we say the banners, when we say we want to take over Freetown in terms of media, you know, for example, when we did do the convention, and no say APC they mean the go McKinney for go do the young convention since not been the same time.
Yeah.
So we wait until we don't make sure say the president don't go McKinney. It's all in people then. 2 o'clock in the middle of the night, we take over
Wilkinson Road.
We make sure say the whole of Wilkinson Road up to Congo Cross to Wilberforce. Any routes where they lead into the convention venue, we make sure say we flood them with mad view in picture. So that anybody where they come for camp contest, you get to understand say this is a mad view territory. It's just media intimidates in a positive way.
Okay.
Because it change people and perspective about you, the way where they see your picture, the way where you look. Even some people not will like you, but just from that picture, they will begin to change their mind. So the media was around matter, the campaign, the way where we changed the campaign is 2018. It's a collective thing, but we don't start this from 2013. Knowing full well say the campaign this time, it's the 21st century. But everything what we do, everything what we want to do within the media, we still at the end of the day will come back to RAM and say, we want to do A, B, C, D. And then he will say, well, no, do A and D, leave C and B till this time. So he's always the boss.
Mm-hmm.
When they come up with the project, yeah. And then the boss decide on the project.
Right. Well, you listen and you look, Mrs. Fatima Bio, inside this special interview. It tell me about in contribution, you know, to Imani campaign. We still carry on with the interview and more on Madabio itself. You know, they say behind every successful man, there is a woman. So they can't tell me who will play for making man reach up to the side. Tell them going to go very soon. Now tell me, what are Madabio?
Madana just a very simple man where he feels for smile.
Mm-hmm.
Not like for smile. Not because they don't get smiling face, but when you don't get into the military for a very long time, you know, it's hard for change you, for make you come and understand that there's another world in a smile world, you know. But no, with all seriousness, it's one of the most dedicated and focused driving man I know, and he means well for Sierra Leone. His project for Sierra Leone, if God help we go through, I'm not saying it would make Sierra Leone a better place for everybody else, not only for choosing few or just one group or region. His intention is to develop the whole of Sierra Leone and to empower the whole of Sierra Leone. You know, I think it just don't fed up with this situation where not only one side they get everything. When Sierra Leone is for everybody and everyone of us, I think that's a matter of your frustration. And I believe, say, even when during the MPRC, when they come and remove APC post time, that was the frustration. Because one side, they always benefit, and everybody else. You have 20% of the Sierra Leonean population benefit, and then 80% of the whole country just languish and perish. So, matter feels, say, 21st century, Sierra Leoneans, therefore, understand and feel that they are Sierra Leoneans and actually benefit from their own country and be proud to call themselves Senegalese.
So how do you, as a film star, they cope with somebody when a military background, the kind they talk about, he had this smile. You know, you now, you don't have a smile inside. So how do they cope?
It's simple. Make sure he smiles. You know, every woman gets a way where you're able to keep your man happy. And when the man is happy, they do positive things. When the man is happy, they focus right and they think well and they do the right thing. And I think that's the weapon between me and my man. Our relationship is based on trust, love, and honesty. So we work in collaboration. We consult each other. We talk about the issues. We agree sometimes, we disagree sometimes. And when we disagree, it's the job for one of the other person to convince the other one why this way is better than that way. And then eventually we will agree. Where we feel, say, no, this one, definitely, we just can't agree. Well, I will make my point. If he still wants to go that way, then, you know, but it will not be a decision we get for the hard one. With Madibio and myself, because from the day when we married, we know, say we married on a pillar of togetherness. We married and know, say yes, this is two become one. We don't work as two become one. And the reason that one did empower me and everything. And all they feel threatened, say, I'm the wife or she would overshadow me. I believe, say, whatever I'm doing, I'm complimenting the things that we're in order to do, because he's just one human being. He cannot be in every place at the same time. So if you get a wife, we compliment the beside him in the lack. That is a progress, not only for him, but for Sierra Leone and the party.
Right. Now let me look at, if he becomes the next president, possibly be able, like for example, you want to take a decision. Will you see, say, no, this decision, it look too strong. You be able for call him up, or possibly be able for just talk to him, and he accepts?
He listens. Okay. He listens. When he feel, if he feel, say, I won't go this way, you know, it's not comfortable. He not only did listen, he consults.
Okay.
He consults. You know, I want to do this. Wait till nothing. And then everybody they give up the unit.